We are approaching the Yamantau bunker, the final destination of our long journey. Direct radio contact with the bunker has completely dissolved Miller's resentment towards me for destroying our previous lives. He is eagerly anticipating the meeting with the Minister of Defense he was promised. Probably such things are important for a career officer. The people, though, are less interested. They are asking important questions. Where are the occupying forces? Why is there just wilderness and people gone wild around? What's stopping the government from restoring the country? What was being done in the last 20 years? Miller believes that we'll get all the answers. He will be pardoned, as well as Anna and I. And we will all return home to the metro.
What are the maintenance people thinking, I wonder?
This place could use some cleaning, at the very least. There's no need for us all to crowd the government, so you two better stay with Krest.
Yes, sir. Sir, yes, sir. It's so quiet. Spooky.
Did you at least prepare a speech? Reporting to the minister is no joke.
Get off my case! I pulled an all-nighter!
Don't you feel like you should say something to Artyom now?
Yes. You were right, Artyom. And I was wrong. Thanks for not giving up. Here goes nothing! Comrade Minister! Commander of the Joint Special Operations Forces Squadron of the City of Moscow, Colonel Miller, reporting! I would like to request that my people are provided with temporary quarters and supplies, as there are women and children among us. Still, our fighters are in top shape and ready for action.
Women and children? Good. Haven't had those in a while.
Who are you?
Everything is going as planned. Everyone is fine. So far.
So far? I demand a meeting with the Minister of Defense, now!
Do not worry. Everything will be just fine. And even better. The Minister and the Chief himself are expecting you for dinner.
Dinner? What the hell? Are you fucking mocking me?
Shut up! The doctor is talking!
Where is the government? Answer!
All here, Colonel. All here. We are the government you people deserve.
Don't you dare, you fuck! You're just fucking cannibals!
Calm down, you'll get jaundice like this. And believe me, nobody likes that bitter taste. The girl will have to wait, though. We must run the tests first. I don't like that cough of hers.
Untie my hands, you motherfucker! And I'll shove those tests so far up your ass, you'll be spitting
them! Watch your tone, young lady. Do as that young man does. He woke up long ago, but quietly listens to wise people talk.
You fucker! Let me go!
Not a single!
So, Colonel, now you will pick up the radio and tell the rest of your people on the train to come here. If you don't want her to suffer for a really long time before she is served. Do you understand? And here I was hoping for an intelligent conversation for a change. Alas. That's not a problem, though, since this nice young man will surely do it instead. He won't dare be contradictory once we're done with you. Well, nice meeting you and all. Yakov, you may start.
I'll get you even after I'm dead.
That may well happen, Colonel. I could choke on you or something. In the meantime, I'll excuse myself.
Come here, I'll rip you all apart. Every last one of you should have done that before the war. But I'll get you now! Burn this scum to ashes! So they're not even their dirty clothes!
Now we'll be full again! Good.
Him. Here.
Colonel, sir, I think that's
thank
enough.
You, son. But it is not. We have to get them. But first, we must fight Anna.
I'm sorry, I went too far with that elevator.
To hell with it! Head off! Start the main elevator off!
D6. Even the lift is the same, exactly.
True, and quite fortunate. This way, we can hope to find Anna. Still, the complex is huge, and we have 10 minutes at the most. So, we'll have to split up. Son, you check the filter room, the generator hall, and the storage. Idiot, you come with me to the command center. Artyom, you take the barracks and the sick bay.
Ah!
Let's go!
Your floor, Artyom.
but there was meat. Meat.
Meat have arrived. Now I know it.
Food is here.
Meat.
What's your choice? You are a drone! I'm here!
Artyom, I knew! Behind you!
There is always one like you, a hero! You're not saving anyone, just like the others. So just...
Freeze!
Yes!
Let him go!
Don't kill me!
Now!
Remember what I told you. There was an
Enough chatter. Are you all right, Artyom? Thank God. Let's report to the Colonel. Dad, it's me.
Anna, are you okay? Where are you?
In the sick bay. Artyom found me.
Oh, thank God. Well done, Artyom. Where do they go now?
There's an elevator straight down the corridor. It goes right to the command center.
Let's go. Not too fast, though. I need to catch my breath a bit. This whole situation, though. I thought we wouldn't see anything worse than that cult on the Volga. And that Silentius with his damn fanatics. But no. It appears there was still space for growth. We could have gotten killed there. We almost got eaten here. Bastard. Unbelievable. To think he used to be a doctor. Don't matter. We'll see what happens now. We did survive him, after all.
With their deceit. Please!
All right, but what do we do now?
I'll be damned if I know, Anna. No idea. Have you found anything, idiot?
Their defense sites, HQs, all the information is outdated. All links are long gone. Still, the ones that light up worked for at least a few years after the war.
What's down there?
It's Caspian 1, a comm center. There's one more just like that in Novosibirsk.
Are you going to drag us to some other bunker
now?
I
don't know, Anna. We have to make the decision together.
Interrupted, but it's quite hot here.
Did you get everything you could, idiot? We're leaving.
One moment. I'll finish breaking everything here.
Come on, come on!
Okay, all done. It all worked out this time, didn't it?
It worked out. It really did. My concern is, what if next time it doesn't?
Right, of course. But you intend to live forever?
Of course not. All the more reason to strive and spend more time of what is allotted to me with that guy over there. I've grown up that just
I believed those pricks from Hansa. I believed that Moscow was controlled by the HQ. That we were under occupation. That we were still in war. That there were generals here giving orders. What an idiot, suka!
I will repeat my question. What do we do now?
Could we go back to Moscow? Tell them the truth about the war. The government.
They'll shoot us on approach. And even if we do break through, what can we do against Hansa? Who'd believe us with no proof?
What about going back to Volga? We could live there.
What do we do about the locals? They weren't exactly happy to see us there. Do we kill them all? Is anybody here up for that?
Back in Moscow, Artyom had been dreaming of finding a habitable place and building a colony there. Isn't it time we got to it?
The idea is good. But how do we find the place? Just keep traveling? The Aurora needs an overhaul. What do we do if it breaks down?
Satellites!
What satellites? You want to leave the fucking planet?
There's a satellite communication center on the Caspian Sea. It survived the war.
Oh. And if we gain access to the data collected by the satellites...
We won't have to travel randomly. Radiation level maps, even your regular satellite photos could really help us out here.
That's an idea.
What if there is something worse than cannibals there?
Could well be. But first, we're going to be really careful this time. And second, does anyone have any better ideas?
I don't.
Well, I guess we've got ourselves a new plan.
Artyom, shall we look for that place you wanted? Sound the horn, then!
Three months on the road, 3 months of constant trial. But after Yamantau, we are ready for anything fate can throw at us. Mere kilometers separate us from the Caspian One communication center. Will the maps within yield a spot free from radiation where we could finally settle in peace? I don't know. But what's left for us but hope? The desert is taking its toll. The crew suffers from heat and thirst, and the Aurora is not in her top form. We're out of coal and had to switch to burning available fuel, old cross ties and twigs.
I'm not in love with this place. Nothing but sand and heat. I feel like shit here.
Somebody lives there.
I see. How are the men doing, Demir?
Stepan is the worst, though. The others are not so well either. Only us here are still in fighting shape.
Thank you. Ara, you and Demir reconnoiter the area. We need to find the damn bunker and hit the road as soon as we do.
We might have a slight problem with hitting the road, Colonel. There's barely enough water in the boiler to make some tea. And we're all out of coal.
I see. We'll need to redress that, too. Ana, Demir, one more task. Look for water and fuel. Sam, get the men ready. We need to set up defenses.
Roger that.
Artyom, come here! Come here, Artyom! Artyom, we have to learn who those men with the car are. They do look like regular bandits, but we can't take risks here. The car was headed for the village. Looks like they have a comms relay there, and it should hold some info, which is just what we need now. Move out as soon as you're ready. Krest, can your rail car pull the train?
It might, but really slowly and not for too long. The engine is too weak for the weight, and we don't have much diesel left.
Well, if we had enough diesel, the Aurora wouldn't be needing any help.
All clear.
Clear.
So, how'd you find the premises, idiot?
Looks like it used to house a ticket office and lockers. Full of garbage now. Could use some cleaning.
Damn, the sun is having a ball today.
Okay. Are you going out? Look here, then. This is something I finished just now. Well, hollowed out a couple of T-Har bullets and filled them with explosive. Some explosive ammo right there. Now, you can do it yourself. It's quite simple. Don't forget to clean your guns regularly, with all the sand around.
Alyosha's trying too hard. Is he overheating? Too much sun, perhaps?
We're all overheating here. I'll relieve him once we get Stepan here.
Yeah, we'll handle that. Well, I'm off too. Thank you.
Artyom! Wait, I'm coming with you. I think I could use a little walk right now.
Stopa, you can hardly walk. You'd better rest while it's not your shift.
Well, Artyom, I really do feel kinda under the weather now. Maybe next time.
You're right. Artyom and Demir are going out for a simple recon, not a fight. Then they'll retreat back to base where you and Sam cover them. So you should rest now.
Yes. You're right, Katya.
How is Stepan doing?
He's got a sunstroke. And he's dehydrated to boot. We should let him rest in a cool place.
The boys are checking the station building now. We'll put him there once they're done.
Oh, I hope they finish soon.
Do you see that building with the antenna? The car went that way. Be careful out there, though. We don't know what to expect from the locals.
You made a mistake coming here.
I surrender!
So, there's probably no chance to have a chat with the owners of this car. What a shame they're so silent. So, if I had a car like this, I wouldn't want to give it up either. In my book, it's a
This is unusual. As far as I remember, we did a pretty good job of teaching the neighbors that actions like this end up costing them. These newcomers seem slow on the uptake. Or not from the neighborhood. In any case, we should find out who they are and what they want. I have called the people that I need separately. The rest of you are to ready your cars, guns, and combat-trained slaves. It might all be needed soon.
As you were, everyone. The Baron has spoken.
There's nobody around. Who'd even go here and what for? Would any tribals help their own?
Look, why don't we just off the fucker? Why do we go to all the trouble for a piece of shit?
You just don't get it. You can't understand what you do.
You've nowhere else to go!
Don't fret! We won't hurt you! The Baron has extended you an offer you can't really afford to decline! Capiche?
Hey! You better calm down while we're fucking asking you nicely! Or I'll drag you to the Baron's on a leash!
Hey, you want to give me yours? You more clothes, but nothing else!
Yeah, sit there all you want. I fucking warned you, though.
Hey, what? What's this?
Watch out!
everyone!
That's it! I surrendered!
At least he accepted my surrender. There's that.
whole body burns!
Who is that?
He's
here! Watch!
I just can't anymore. Feeling weak.
Thank you.
curse you, Shaitan! You killed that dog well!
We need a medic here!
Yes! We kill all of those dogs, then drink some tea! Is everything quiet? Are they all dead? Come up here then!
It hurts. Oh, I'm dirty whore.
You, it's Shaitan.
fucking pig!
Come off to the ledge!
You enemy?
Are you Artyom? Come in. Whoever kills the Moon Eye by Lair is my friend. The Moon Eye by Lair, as we call them, turned my people into slaves. Wanted to put me in shackles too. Better dead.
Nobody would come here save for Moon Eye by Lair.
What do you know of the antennas near your lighthouse?
There used to be a comm center before the war. My mother worked there. She was an officer. The facility is long abandoned. I went there after war to look for Mom's traces, but found nothing. I will help.
Artyom, you have to find the archive. It should be near the command center. Look for shots taken after the war, starting with the year 2013. The Nier will soon be there. You can count on him. Miller, over and out.
If we go, we'd better go now, before more of them arrive. Use the workbench if you need to fix something. There are all kinds of danger. A smart man wouldn't go there. You seem smart, but you do not have choice.
Ready? No? Make haste then, we don't have much time. Before war, this place was beautiful. See, I was 5 then. My mom was young, alive. Now it's just desert. All the beasts changed into freaks, and people became beasts. My people became chattel. Not by themselves. The oil dogs made them. The oil stayed even though the sea dried out. Old people died. Only the young remained. And they all obey their masters now. The Moon Eye by Lair say they're gods of fire now. And the young believe. 5 years after the war, my mother died. I was all alone.
know how to open the door, so I've been there. But I never went deep. There are spiders. See the passage? You go through. I'll follow.
We're up a shit creek without a pedal. The cracks on the lower level that last earthquake opened are now seeping gas. And that gas is toxic if I know anything. The ventilation is so far keeping it big. But what if the power shuts off again? Or we get another tremor and the crack opens wide. I told the chief, but he's just pulling his usual. Sit on your ass in your office, drink and twiddle your thumbs.
Thank you.
up for the lift. If you already have the map, just wait for your eyes.
After all,
come true.
You can't